മൈ സീറ്റ് ഓൾഡ് മെമ്മറീസ് ഓഫ് എ വിസിറ്റ് ഓഫ് അമൃതാനന്ദമയി ദേവി ആശ്രമം വള്ളിക്കാവ് കൊല്ലം. അമൃതപുരി ആശ്രമം ദ ബർത്ത് പ്ലേസ് ഓഫ് അമ്മ ഈസ് നൗ ദി ഹെഡ് ക്വാർട്ടേഴ്സ് ഓഫ് അമ്മാസ് വേൾഡ് വൈഡ് മിഷൻ. All devotee residents in this big ashramam have dedicated their lives for realizing God and servicing the world. Many devotees from India and abroad come here to enjoy Amma's darshan. She sees each and everyone, listen to their worries, consoles, encourages, provides new direction to their lives. Amma is known worldwide as the hugging saint. Amrutapuri is the living example of the ancient India ideal. The world is one family. Here you will find people from all parts of the world speaking different languages and having different customs and religions, all living under one roof. It is a remote fishing village on small island dedicated between the backwaters of Kayangulam Kayal and the Arabian Sea has become the center of silent spiritual revolution. Even from her childhood, Amma spent hours meditating and composed devotional songs. Amma was born in Parayakadavu, now known as Amrutapuri, near Vallikavu in Kollam in 1953, the third child of Sugunanandan and Damayanti in fishing community. As a child, she used to collect food and clothing and distribute to the poor. She also started embracing people to comfort them in their sorrows. In the 9th year, she stopped school life. Because her mother was ill, she began to do household works and take care of her siblings. She rejected several attempts by her parents and relatives to get married and continued her spiritual work. In 1979, Amma's devotees formed an ashram known as Amrutapuri. Now it runs as a parent organization trust under which several spiritual, educational, cultural, health care organizations perform. The famous Amrutha Hospital in Ernakulam and dozens of education institutions in Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, which function under the Amrutha deemed university, are among them. Amma was one of the representative of the Hinduism at the Parliament of the World's Religion at Chicago in 1993. There has been times when she sat 20 hours on a stretch during the darshan time, hugging up to 50,000 devotees. Amma has been attacked twice, both at her Amrutapuri ashram. A man named Pavitran tried to attack her with a knife in 2005, while a Bihari youth called Satnam Singh attacked her in 2012. Amma executes various charitable work all over the world. Her network of charity organizations exist in 14 countries around the world and provide food, housing, education, and medical services to the people in need. Since 2012, she has been involved in cleaning the Pamba River as well as Sabarimala Temple pilgrimage site annually. In 2015, she donated rupees 100 crore to the Government of India Clean Ganga program to construct toilets for poor families living alongside the river Ganga. The ashram is 2.5 hours north, 3 hours south of Kochi. Nearest railway station is Kollam, about 33 km away. Nearest airport is Trivandrum International Airport, 101 km away. Kochi Airport is 140 km. You can online registration for accommodation. Due to Corona, now it is closed. Accommodation is available in the ashrama. Identity card is a must. Free food is available there. There is also a canteen and fruit and juice stall, stationery shop, book stall, bank, ATM counter, foreigners canteen, Ayurveda hospital, allopathy hospital are inside the ashramam. At Amrutapuri, the ashramites and the devotees form a big family under Amma, and together they celebrate many religious festivals: Onam, Vishu, God Krishna's Janmashtami, Mahashivaratri, Holi, etc. When Amma is not giving darshan, she is leading the ashramites meditation, instructing them in their spiritual practices, identifying them with her immortal wisdom. There are classes in yoga, Sanskrit, Vedanta and meditation. To get into the ashramam, you need to register with an ID. The room rent is 250 per night with 3 meals on 2015. Amma is not at Amrutapuri all the time, but she spends a lot of months traveling in India and foreign countries. Amrutanandamayi Devi Madam ashram is in all the main cities of India, and there are many ashrams in foreign countries. Amma stays in Amaradhapuri about 4 months a year. She is in the ashram August and September and most of December. From January till the end of March, she is usually tours India, staying ashram when not on tour. Amma travels internationally in April, May, June, July, August, September, November. Check her travels, plans to visit Amaradhapuri. On Monday and Friday afternoon, Amma leads the meditation on the beach and guides the question and answers mission.